everybody, and welcome to another episode of Mental Architecture, Building the Mind One Moment at a Time. I'm Howard Blumenfeld, the author of this book, Mental Architecture, Building the Mind One Moment at a Time, which is available exclusively on Amazon. If you've ever had trouble making a decision or felt indecisive, then this video is definitely for you. So I'm going to talk about some of the neurological and psychological causes of indecisiveness and what you can do about them. The ability to make your own decisions is extremely important. We have to make choices all the time. We have to decide what we're going to eat, what we're going to wear, where we're going to go. And if you don't make decisions quickly enough, then what can happen is you just get frustrated. You know, best case scenario, worst case scenario, somebody else persuades you and makes a decision for you. So we all know people in our lives who are indecisive, and I think everybody can be indecisive at one time or another, but what causes it in the brain? And so some researchers aim to figure that out, and they use transcranial magnetic stimulation, or TMS, to determine what causes indecisiveness. Now, the researchers use an alternating current to either increase or decrease the flow of information between the prefrontal cortex and the parietal cortex, so those two different parts of the brain, basically either increasing or decreasing information flow in the process. While the research subjects were basically asked to make preference-based or sensory-based, perceptual-based decisions that had to do with food. Now, the results of this study were pretty surprising. So what the researchers found was that when they decreased the information flow between the two cortices, participants became more indecisive and they had trouble making decisions, both on the preferences and also sensory decisions that had to do again with the perception. And that was really interesting because on the flip side of things, when the researchers increased the information flow between the two cortices, there was really no measurable difference in decisive ability. So they didn't see like a dramatic increase in decisiveness. So what the researchers concluded is that there appears to be a certain threshold by which people have to have a certain amount of cortical activity going on or information transfer between those two cortices to be able to make decisions. And if that information isn't flowing fast enough, then people become indecisive. They become more indecisive. But having a faster information flow doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to become more decisive. So it appears to be negatively affected by a slowdown in the processing, but it's speeded up and it doesn't seem to really do much. So it's thought that people who are chronically indecisive may have impaired cortical processing in those regions. And while there isn't any pharmacological therapy for these people right now, there might be medicines and treatments in the future that could help people become more decisive. But as we saw in the experiment, only so much. So what other kind of things can people do to become more decisive? And so to look for answers, you know, from like a psychological standpoint, we have to look at another phenomenon which everybody engages in. It's, you know, throughout the day, at some point during the day, we all engage in mind wandering or daydreaming. What's really interesting about that is that when you let your mind wander and you go off into la la land, you actually end up having a harder time making decisions. So people who are more mentally present and who are focused on being in the here and the now and aware of their surroundings tend to be more capable of making decisions. And this is thought to be the case because people who have a higher incidence of mind wandering tend to also be unhappier. This has been shown in research studies. So what the researchers recommend is that people who find themselves, you know, with daydreaming a lot and not focusing, encourage them to practice, you know, focusing on things. You could start with just like grabbing like a rock or another object, like an orange, holding it in your hand, feeling the orange in your hand, and really focusing on it. And you could do this with, you know, other objects too. You could run your fingers through your hair and just focus on the sensations that you feel while you do that. This is actually a very common psychological therapy technique that clinical psychologists use to help people overcome anxiety, but it can also be applied to decisiveness in this very indirect kind of way. Although there's no objective proof that this will work, you know, If you think about it from an intuitive standpoint, it makes sense that being more mentally present and being more aware of your surroundings would also help you to be more aware of your preferences. So, you know, and since decisiveness occurs in that frontal cortex area and sort of the parietal cortex, that's an area that's highly associated with judgment. And so being aware of your surroundings, being aware of yourself, being aware of things in front of you can help you to become more aware of your perceptions and aware of, again, your preferences so you can make better decisions about things. But what this leads to is it's mindfulness. Mindfulness, there was a huge mindfulness revolution that's happened in the past few decades, and I have a whole section on it. It's actually the last section of the sixth chapter in my book, and I really would like to, you know, devote a whole nother video to talking about mindfulness. So I just want to thank everybody for coming and watching another mental architecture video. I hope you enjoyed this one, and if you want to stick around for some more videos, be sure to subscribe. I point banner above me, but you actually want to subscribe down there. Like and comment, and you can see my other videos. There will be a little carousel at the end of this video that will show you other videos that you can choose to watch. I have about 32 other videos covering all the sections of my book. So I try to do one of these weekly, and so I'll be back next week with another one. I hope everybody has a great day. Take care. Bye.